So one question I get asked often, can you play AAA games on Apple products? Well, in most cases, you can't. There is the odd exception. However, today what I want to do is I want to show you how it's possible to play AAA games on basically any kind of Apple device out there what has a screen and has the ability to stream at the same time. And this is possible by GeForce Now, created by Nvidia. So let me show you, for example, what I've got here. I have here a MacBook Air M2, and this is running Cyberpunk 2077 on it, and it works at 60 frames per second. Another device that I have right here is the brand new iPad Pro, and this is the M2 chipset model, and again, it can run the latest AAA games on it. Not only this, you're probably wondering, what about iPhones? Well, yep, you can do it on an iPhone. This is an iPhone 14 Pro Max, and you can play games on this too. And I can keep on going. For example, the brand new generation iPad that's come out here, the 10th generation, can also play the latest games. And then finally, just for the fun of it as well, an iPad mini can also play the latest games. To play on a Mac, for example, like my M2 MacBook Air that I have here, all you have to do is go onto this link I'm showing right now, and then afterwards, click on the client. I'm going to click for macOS, and all you have to do is just download it. As easy as that. After this, what you need to do is create an account and everything, and once you're all set up, you'll have a screen just like this one here, showing all the different games, and you can link up all your games from, say, your Steam store, or your Epic Games Store, or even from Ubisoft as well. And as you can see, there's a big variation of different games, AAA games that you can link into this. And I'll talk more about the subscription and how this all works in a bit. But right now, I know what we want to do. We want to play a game. So I'm going to load up Planet Coaster, first of all, just to show you this, how easy it is to work. And remember, this is all being streamed over right now. That's the great thing about this service, like I will talk about a bit more further on into the video. So just loading up here, just syncing over my game and everything. And we're just going to load up Planet Coaster as the first demo game here. And it seems like it's working all fine. Everything's loading up like it normally would do. We should see the planet coming up in a second. There you go, the frontier. The guy kicking it. I'm going to skip that. And we're just going to go straight into the game. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on resume. Yeah, let's go and resume. Let's continue on the game. And everything seems to be loading really smoothly and everything. And there we go. We're into the game. Now, I'm playing this on my trackpad on my Mac, so it's not probably the best interface. You probably recommend the mouse or a controller. What you can also use, as you can see, I'm just moving around a bit. Oh, my zoom. Nope. I'm not very good at this. It's no good on the trackpad. Yeah, do not use a trackpad. Use something else. But yeah, it's all working fine. And in fact, let's move over to something a bit better, like Cyberpunk 2077. As you can see here, this is more like it. You can actually see the big difference here. We're playing on a triple game here and flinging it around. You can see that no stutter whatsoever. It's absolutely fantastic. And at the moment, I believe I'm playing at 60 frames per second at the moment from the cloud at the moment, the Nvidia GeForce Cloud. But it's absolutely amazing, the graphics settings that I'm getting here. I'm getting, as you can see on the floor there, I'm getting some ray tracing, the light reflections, live ray tracing. That's really, really cool, and shadows and everything. And it does look absolutely superb. I cannot believe I actually am playing a AAA game here on a MacBook Air M2. So that's how you can play the latest sort of games on your MacBook, or let's say a iMac, or let's say a Mac Mini, or the Mac Studio, or any kind of sort of Mac device you have out there. And remember, if your device also has, say, ProMotion built into it, remember you can play at 120 frames per second, like on those new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros. That's really, really cool, especially at resolutions at 1440p. But what about, say, like the iPad that we have here? This is the 10th generation brand new iPad, as you can see. And this one here, you're probably wondering, well, how do games work on this? Well, this is quite simple too. How games are played on this iPad, or say on an iPhone, is that you can do it via Safari. The setup is very, very easy to go through to get everything set up. And then after that, all you have to do is just go and open basically a shortcut, what you have on your sort of main sort of menu on the home screen, on your iPad or your iPhone. And then after this, you'll launch open into kind of a window like this, with all your different games that you've added via, say, Steam and sort of like Epic Games or any other kind of sort of availability. I think it's Ubisoft as well that can work with this. And basically what you can do is you can click on the game that you want to play. You can click play. And then basically the game will start up automatically. So again, I'm going to be launching Cyberpunk onto this. And you can see it's saying my rig is ready. I can click continue. And there we go. I'm straight into the game and I can start playing right away. Now, something else what you can also do is you can actually use a controller with your iPad or your iPhone. So I've hooked up an Xbox controller with it and it works absolutely amazing. So say you're not a big fan of Macs or iPads or iPhones, that's what I'm a big fan of, but let's say you're a big fan of Windows and you're a big fan of Android too, you can also play the latest and greatest games on that. And you can do that by your PC, you can download the same sort of app, what's similar to the one what's on the Mac, and also at the same time as well, you can also download an app on Android if you want to play your games via there. And you can also hook up a controller too. So it's really useful to know that literally that GeForce Now is available on so many different platforms and there's so many different ways to play, which is really, really cool. So I've shown you guys a bit of a demo around the streaming ability of GeForce Now, and it does look really, really awesome, but I want to talk more about the actual service. So like I've shown you Cyberpunk 2077, I've shown you Planet Coaster, and they're really, really working well. But you're probably wondering about kind of the different services that are out there and what is available. So first of all, you do have the free tier available, and you guys can try this out right now. And in fact, I'm putting a link on below right now for you to go and test this out. And this allows you to play unlimited 1 hour slots of games on basically GeForce Now. If you do have like a Steam account, an Epic Store account, or an Ubi Store account, you can link them up to your GeForce Now account. And with that, you can play games that are kind of a bit of a lower resolution, and you can only play up to 1 hour, but it's free to do it. So yeah, do check that out. The second tier is called the Priority Membership, and you can get this for £8.99, or you can get this for $9.99. And with this, you can actually play games at 1080p and up to 60 frames per second, what is more than perfect for, say, like this iPad you have right here, or for example, let's say if you have a normal sort of iPhone or a Pro series, what has a 60Hz refresh rate on that. On that too, you also do get things like ray tracing and DLSS, what I will talk about a little bit later on into this video. But then after that, if you want to go for the big guns, what you can also go is you can go onto the actual RTX 3080. And with this, it only costs you £17.99 UK pounds and $19.99 US dollars per month. And on this service, you get an RTX 3080 and you can play games at 1440p and up to 120 frames per second, was absolutely amazing. So you do have one of those MacBook Pros out there, which does have a ProMotion display. You should be able to play at 120 frames per second, was absolutely amazing to try this out. You also do get things, like I said before, you get ray tracing and you also get DLS as well. And that's what I did want to talk about, that you do get those features, that sort of ray tracing and DLS sort of capabilities are quite new in the last series of sort of Nvidia sort of graphics card series. And it's really, really good to use that on sort of AAA games that are out there right now. For example, if you look at Cyberpunk sort of 2077 here, you can see the reflections working really, really well with sort of that ray tracing. And with DLSS as well, you also get that also crisp sort of smoothing, moving around with sort of flicking the camera around with that DLS sort of SS ability built into it too. So I really do love that availability is available by streaming this onto your tablet or onto your phone or onto your MacBook. So there are some other features that I also want to mention, is that the Nvidia sort of GeForce Now doesn't actually secure onto your sort of game library out there. So what I mean by this, if you actually got a Steam library, or if you've got like an Epic Games library, for example, and you sort of sign up and sync your games over to GeForce Now, if you were to cancel GeForce Now at any time, your games will still stay inside your Steam library, in your Epic Games account or your Ubisoft account. None of those games would actually disappear. It just gives you the ability to stream your games. That's all it's giving you the ability to do. So that's really, really cool. And talk about the amount of games that you can play. Not every single game is compatible, but over 1,300 games are compatible, and most of them are AAA games out there. Games like Cyberpunk 2077 that I've shown you here, Daylight 2 for example, Apex Legends, you can play Fortnite as well. A lot of the sort of top games out there right now that are coming out and ones that are coming out into the future will work with no problems on Nvidia's GeForce Now, and new games are added every Thursday, every week. So that's really, really cool to actually hear that. And finally, one of my favourite features that's built into GeForce Now is that whenever a brand new game comes out, normally within the first couple of weeks, there's probably loads of updates coming out and you have to wait around to download them before you can actually start playing a game. With GeForce Now, all of that is handled in the cloud, so you can just start playing right away. You don't have to wait for updates or anything like that. It's all handled in the cloud, and that's really, really good that you can just jump into gaming straight away, and I absolutely love that ability. So then guys, what do you think of GeForce Now? Will you be playing AAA games on your iPad or your Mac or your iPhone? I would love to know. Put it down in the comments below if you're going to be trying this out. And remember, do check out the link that I'm also displaying right now to do check out GeForce Now. And remember, you can have up to a 1 hour session, or you have a limited 1 hour session to try it out. And remember, you do have more tiers as well to try out if you want to have, say, a RTX 3080, for example. But I've been really, really happy with my service that I have. The Wi-Fi has been absolutely great and the streaming ability has been awesome on all of my devices, and also trying out 5G, for example, on my iPhone 14 Pro Max has also been incredible to stream games. And with that guys, it's also to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button, and also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also make sure you hit the subscription button and also hit that notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you soon. Take care. Bye bye.